Several thousand years ago, a large volcanic eruption began in western Nevada. It was so energetic that it caused a plume of ash to shoot more than 26,000 feet or 8 kilometers into the atmosphere. Simultaneously, pyroclastic flows raced across the landscape, burying everything in a vast area in superheated rock. These pyroclastic flows traveled at least 1.5 miles before coming to a stop. For the next several hours, powerful explosions continued at the source vent, carving a larger and larger volcanic crater. By the time the eruption had ended, what remained was a series of two large complex craters. The first and larger crater measured 1.5 miles long and 3/4 of a mile wide. The other measured 1,300 feet long and 1,100 feet wide. What had just occurred was a mar-forming explosive eruption of the Soda Lakes volcano, likely registering as either a 3 or possibly even a 4 on the Volcanic Explosivity Index. Today, this volcanic complex is still geothermally active and powers a local geothermal power plant. And more than 10,000 people now live within a 10-mile radius of this volcano, which could all be theoretically placed at risk if it was to ever erupt again. The Soda Lakes volcano is located 6.25 miles west-northwest of the city of Fallon within Nevada's Churchill County. Unlike many other volcanoes within the United States, its main feature is not a several thousand foot tall mountain, obvious group of lava flows, or even a recognizable cinder cone, which are fairly common across the western United States. Instead, the main feature of the Soda Lakes volcano consists of two explosion craters referred to as MARS. However, this complex does in fact contain four volcanic cones, three tuff cones are located 6 to 10 miles north of the MARS, and a highly eroded cinder cone known as Rattlesnake Hill just northeast of the city of Fallon. With the exception of Rattlesnake Hill, you might note that the two MARS, three tuff cones, and in the active geothermal field are located along the north-northeastern trend. And if you zoom out further, you will note other mountain ranges which also have the same orientation. This same orientation is not merely a coincidence, but rather exists in almost the entirety of the state of Nevada, being part of what is known as the Basin Range Province. Here, the crust is slowly spreading apart to the east and west, creating large swaths of terrain which largely look the same. This extension creates a series of large fault lines in the crust, creating uplifted patches of land known as horse, and subsided patches of ground known as grabens. Over millions of years, this process created large mountain ranges and valleys. Upwelling mantle material then used these faults as a path of least resistance, creating magmatic intrusions, some of which eventually erupted onto the surface, forming scattered volcanic fields. Although there are no obvious lava flows at the two Soda Lake MARS, from satellite you can see due to the presence of darker colored ground where thick ash fell during the eruption, which occurred less than 10,000 years ago. And if you walk around the Soda Lakes, you might even be able to see small bombs of lava of a basaltic composition. Although it is uncertain when exactly this explosive eruption occurred, the US Geological Survey suggests that it occurred sometime in the last 6,000 years. One source even suggested the eruption is less than 1,500 years old, but this is less certain. As for the other vents, Rattlesnake Hill is 1 million years old, while the three tuff cones referred to as the Hogback Cones are anywhere between 10,500 and 18,000 years old, as noted in a thesis by E. Anderson. This means that the Soda Lakes complex might have erupted not once, but twice since the end of the last ice age, aka 11,650 years ago. Although it does not have the typical appearance of a volcano, the extent ash and pyroclastic flows travel during the eruptions is quite visible from satellite. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on this channel's Patreon page.